Hi, my name is Dr. Edmondson, and I am a neurologist at Bon Secours St. Mary's Hospital in Richmond. And I want to take a few minutes to talk to you about the ways you and your family can prevent stroke. If you have any questions, please submit your questions, and I will get to it at the end. So the month of May is Stroke Awareness Month, and my colleagues and I are trying to get the word out about what stroke is, how to recognize it, how you can prevent it from happening to you and your loved ones. Just like a heart attack happens when blood flow to the heart is blocked, a stroke happens when blood flow to a part of the brain is disrupted, either from a blockage in a blood vessel or bleeding into the brain. The signs for stroke can vary from very mild to very severe and can happen suddenly. The more common signs of stroke include slurred speech, difficulty with balance, dizziness, loss of vision, weakness to the body, facial droop. An easy way to remember stroke signs is the tool BFAST. So BFAST stands for B as in balance, E for eye, such as vision loss or double vision, F for face, facial droop, S for speech, slurred speech, T, and T is most important for T in time is brain. It's only been in recent years that we can really effectively treat stroke, and we can only do that within certain periods of time. That's why it's so important that if you or anyone you're with has stroke signs or symptoms, it is crucial for you to get to the hospital as soon as you can, preferably a stroke center. What we know is that stroke is the fifth leading cause of death in the United States and one of the most prevalent permanent causes of disability in the world. What we also know is that stroke is one of the most preventable disease conditions. There are several risk factors for stroke. These include high cholesterol, being diabetic, smoking, your age, and family history. But the number one risk factor for stroke is high blood pressure, also called hypertension. Hypertension is the most common chronic medical condition worldwide. Hypertension can develop for many reasons, to include your family history, your smoking status, excessive alcohol intake, being overweight, or any other underlying disease conditions like kidney disease. But one of the most common reasons why people develop hypertension is because of what they eat, their daily diet. So that brings me to the DASH diet. DASH stands for Dietary Approaches to Stop Hypertension. This is a research-based, studied, and endorsed plan by the National Institutes of Health, where it is designed to lower blood pressure without the use of medications or to lower your requirement for medication. The DASH diet is mainly a plant-focused diet that has added lean meats of poultry and fish, whole grains, and heart-healthy fats. Not only has it been shown to reduce your blood pressure, but it could also reduce your LDL, which is your bad cholesterol, increase your good cholesterol, the HDL, help weight loss, prevent diabetes, and now, most importantly, has been shown to reduce depression. Keep in mind that the DASH diet is not a fat-free diet. It is not a vegetarian diet. It's not a fad diet. It's actually an eating plan that will help retrain the way we eat in using more balanced meals with increased fruits, vegetables, proteins, and heart-healthy fats. This diet is typically 2,000 calories per day. You're encouraged to eat three meals, and as long as they have the right balance of proteins, lean meats, fruits and vegetables, with very minimized sugared products, you're on the right track. For people who are trying to reduce sodium specifically, there is a DASH diet with greater sodium reduction, which has greater health benefits. The key point of the DASH diet is that this is a science-backed eating plan that can lower your blood pressure without medications, making this one of the first steps and possibly one of the easiest steps at reducing your risk for stroke. For more information about stroke and prevention, please join my colleagues and I at the annual Jazz Up Your Health event this month on May 31st at the Richmond Convention Center. This is a free event to the community where we can teach about stroke, talk to experts, have a night with dinner and music. In fact, there will be a cooking demonstration to show you how to implement the DASH diet at home. So thank you for joining me, and we hope to see you on May 31st.
How does salt work to increase your blood pressure?
Too much salt in your diet will increase your blood pressure by retaining too much fluid. So if you minimize your salt, hopefully your pressure will also follow suit.
How does the DASH diet compare to the food pyramid or my plate? Is it the same number of servings of vegetables and so on, or is it different?
In the DASH diet, I find that there's less dairy products as opposed to the traditional food pyramid. Servings are less, so you are on a 2,000 calorie diet typically, but the diet range can go from 1,600 to 3,000 calories per day. The main thing is that you want to avoid processed foods, sugared drinks, sweetened foods.
What happens if I get off the DASH diet?
Ideally, if you're on the DASH diet, you should have retrained the way you eat. So you should not really leave the DASH diet because it becomes a part of your habits. If you do leave the DASH diet, you may notice that you won't feel as good. You may feel more sluggish. You may have more sugar crashes, and your blood pressure could rise.
Arlene asks, how do you join the diet?
So the DASH diet is something pretty well known. It's been around for 8 years. There's a lot of literature on the internet. There's even books about the DASH diet with recipes, very straightforward, that you can do at home. At the event we're going to have, we will have a nutritionist, a dietitian there, and a cooking demonstration. So hopefully they'll be able to show you hands-on how to really make those recipes to really accommodate the DASH diet.
Do I need to ask my doctor before I start the DASH diet?
It's always good practice to ask your doctor, because if you have underlying diabetes, really hard to control hypertension, you know, you should bring that up with your doctor, because the 2,000 calories or less or more may not be very appropriate for you.
Is the DASH diet appropriate for all ages?
Right now, we haven't seen any literature to say it's not good for all ages. We know that currently in America, children are getting too much sugar in their diet, and the DASH diet really is part of the focus is to reduce how much sugar you intake. So I'm not seeing any contraindications for children to use the DASH diet. I think we should just employ judicious use of our foods, balance our proteins and carbohydrates, and avoid processed food as much as possible.
How does the DASH diet work with exercise?
There is no restriction on exercise with the DASH diet. The DASH diet is really part of what you do every day, and you still should implement exercise as you normally would.
Do I need any special foods, or can I just buy things at the grocery store?
The nice part about this diet is that you don't need special food ordered online. This is really what's available at the grocery stores. Organic or not organic, that's a personal choice, but there really is no restriction on where you can get your food products.
Thank you, Dr. Edmondson. Do you have anything else to add?
Thank you for joining me, and we'll see you on May 31st.